the heavenly language and also our own languages. Hallelujah. And remember that whenever you come before the Lord, you have to tune into the heavenly language for you to tap what is belonging to the heaven. Amen? We call it vertical relationship and horizontal relationship should be merging. Hallelujah. So, the foundation that we lay today will determine our tomorrow. Say amen. Amen. The foundation that God has started in your life will determine the end of your everything. Say amen.
Amen.
So, I wanted to zero down to a certain man in the Bible. This man, we know him. He is a man of a good example to a human life. He is a man that we have to eliminate. We have to copy. Sorry, today we are not going to use Swahili. Let me use English. Up to that point that I feel that I'll use Swahili. Amen? So tune in to this language because this one must not pass you. We need you also to tune into this. Amen? Number one, we have said there is a man in the Bible, a man with desire, a man of God's heart. Though we have seen so many events taking place in the Bible, but I will zero down to one man that will lay a foundation at this place. Hallelujah. This man is called Abraham. Abraham was just a common man, the way you are common. Amen?
Amen.
Abraham was just a man born from a woman, same the way you were born from a lady or a woman. But there is something different that Abraham did that establishes him up to today. We are talking of Abraham. Hallelujah. The heading of today is when God changes your title. Hallelujah. When God changes your title, the title will be there forever. Because our God is God of permanence. Our God is a God of ages. Our God is the God of any season you think of. So today, please, tune into this that your title will be changed. Tell your neighbor. Aye. Today is a class. And this class, check on this microphone. I think it's the mixer. I'm telling you this because I want you to have a new title from today. I want you to be established from today. The year 2021 is our year of greater grace and divine restoration. What does it mean? It is our year of divine restoration. To be restored is to be moved from rags to a better place. Praise Jesus. So, when God changes your title, tell your neighbor. Today. Today, I'm changing my title. Title number one, I'll be called a giver. Be serious. You know, you don't want to change your title. People who want to change the title, they say things with a lot of confidence. Remember last week we said confidence is the thing that we have to be done in the area.
This year.
Neighbor, I'll be changing my title to be called a giver. Hallelujah. This year, I'll be called a giver. Haijalishi una give nini. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, you may have good and respectful titles. You are the head of an institution. You have a good title. You are a good mother in the house. You have a good title. You are a good brother in the church. You have a good title. Hallelujah. That you need to be addressed with every time. You know, this is Doctor Who. This is Saplani. Hallelujah. They will address you with those titles. I know. Every person here needs a title. Amen. Yeah. Every time you sit and somebody just calls you David, you don't feel good. You want to have, this is an IT engineer. Hallelujah. You have to check your title. Whisper to your neighbor. Which title do you want you to be called? Yes. Yes, in the kingdom. Leave away other things. In the kingdom. Hallelujah. Us in the house, we want to be addressed like the kings of the house. Hallelujah. Because we are the bosses of the house. Yes. But when the title changes to be called just a name your mother gave you, you change your face. Hallelujah. But I know that God will not address you the way man addresses you. Hey, are you getting this? God will not address you the way we address you. God does not respect your title as an engineer. Remember, Bible says, God is not the respecter of persons. Hallelujah. It is God who is the builder in the garden. Hallelujah. Are you getting what I'm saying? That he is going to establish a new title on your life that will never be changed by any person. Let us look at the book of Genesis. 12. 1 to 3. The Lord said to Abraham, look at the name Abraham. After he has not met with God, the name was very short, even the counting of the letters. Abraham, go out from your land to your relatives and your father's house to the land that I will show you. I will make you into a great nation. I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. Three. I will bless those who bless you. Titles. Amen. I will curse those who treat you with contempt, and all the peoples on earth will be blessed through you. Let us focus on the meeting between God and Abraham. When God met Abraham, Abraham was like just any other person. The way I say it, it was like you. Praise God. But when God met Abraham, God turned the name Abraham to be Abraham. Because God had a purpose with the word and the life and everything that Abraham will go through. Amen. And the Bible says that the Lord had said to Abraham, leave your country. For you to be transformed, you have to leave your past. You have to leave the culture. You have to leave your perception. You have to leave what you belong to. Amen. If God wants to beat you, God needs you to be pure. God does not need you to have attachment with other things so that he blesses you. Praise God. When we come to the normal perspective of life, you find that a man wants to be blessed. A man wants to move ahead. A man wants to do something. But because of the perception that there is an attachment behind me, you will not be able to move. Amen? Amen. So God is calling upon you that come, you, the name that you have, that God will change that name to a better name so that he starts working on you. God does not depend on the foundation that you lay.
Hallelujah.
Am I getting it? I need an amen. I need an amen.
Amen.
The foundations that we have put in our lives, the wife that we chose to be our wives, the people that we chose to be our husbands, God does not look at them first before he blesses you. God will call you out to be you alone so that you come and God to treat you the way he wants you to be treated.
Amen. Glory.
Amen. Leave alone all the titles. I am a mathematician teacher and I know that I have a title. But I will have to remove all the titles so that I can meet with my maker.
Amen.
Amen. So for you to be blessed, I'm thinking about the blessing. Amen. You have to leave your title alone. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The title must be wrapped fast. The title must be you a giver. Because, let us look at this. God gave. God gave his only begotten
son.
Am I talking to somebody? This is a class. We have to talk. Eh? God gave his only begotten
son.
So that whoever, there is no title of whoever we believe.
Uh-huh.
Amen. There is no title of an engineer to believe. There is no title of a wife to believe. There is no title of a husband to believe. There is no title of a child to believe. But whoever believes.
Amen. Glory.
Hallelujah. So that when you believe in him. Let us go to John 3:16, my brother. So that we see how God can meet you. God does not respect that title that you get. Amen. John 3:16. I want to show you where the title comes in. It is God who establishes the title. For God loved the world in this way. He gave his one and only son. So that everyone. Amen. So that everyone. You cannot tell me that my husband, I'm not going to church because I feel that you have done this and this to me. I'm telling you, it is for everyone, whether you like it or not. If you don't take it, another person is taking it. Even if you don't go to church, there is somebody going. But I'm telling you, it is you alone.
Amen.
Amen. Everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life.
Yes.
So whoever believes in this will not die.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Hallelujah. Your business will not die if you believe in this. The foundation. Amen. The foundation. If you believe in the foundation, if you believe in Christ, if you believe in the begotten Son, it is only the trust will establish you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory.
We have said, leave your land. Leave everything that you belong to.
Mm-hmm.
My friend, don't think of that business that God has given you.
Uh-huh.
Leave it alone. Don't think of that husband God has given you. Leave him alone. Don't think of that wife God has given you. Leave him alone and focus on God alone.
Amen. Glory.
Living. The term is living.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what people are saying outside there. That these people, they go to church and they are not blessed. Amen. We are not measured by the earthly things. Hallelujah. We are measured with the heavenly things. And I know when God says yes, nobody can say
no.
If you have the answer in the church, which foundation do you want to have if it's not Christ? Amen. Lead them. Now, let us zero down to what Pastor Benny was saying. I want all hands up. Everybody's hand to be up. And I want to count. Hallelujah. Praise God. There is a perception that men have in their life. There is a perception that men have in their lives that I'm not blessed. Hallelujah. From Monday up to today, who had not received anything in cash or in terms of money? Raise up your hand. Those hands must remain in the air. I want to have those hands in the air. Yes. Hey, come on, Pastor Richard, be weak. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Umeinua mkono, si ndio? Haujapata chochote. May God supply.
Amen.
May God supply.
Amen.
That next time, He will bless you. He will change that title.
Amen. Glory.
Amen. That title is going to change. And those who have put down their hands, let us leave the last go and things. Amen. Amen. Hey, my wife. You got something this way. Yes? And I didn't know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm telling you that if we have that, we leave that mentality that God has not blessed me, we are going to go far.
Amen.
Amen. If God has blessed you with something this week, again, raise up your hand. What are you saying? We are in the church. If God blesses you with something this week, just raise up your hand. Kibarua, nini, chakula, nini. It's your thing. God gave you this one. Amen. And I know God is going to extend your boundary. Say amen.
Amen.
If you purpose to be the name I gave you in the beginning, to be a giver. Amen. I need a hand clap. Because we are changing titles. We are changing titles this season. We are changing titles in this place. We are changing titles.
Uh-huh.
Amen?
Amen.
God is going to take us places if we change that title that we don't have. Amen. You leave your land and go to a place I'm going to show you. This is the place God is going to show us. This is the place.
Amen.
I'm telling you, when we think of buying this land, this is the place. We are thinking of that that thing. Pastor, am I right?
You're right.
And it is by power that God has given us. We have to move from where we are. We are at comfort zones. That is why God is not acting on our lives. Are you getting that point?
Yes.
We are at our comfort zone. And God told Abraham, move from your comfort zone. Move from where you are. Move from what you are thinking you have. Move from whatever you think that you can do. Just focus on God. And God will expand you.
Amen.
Amen? If you start a business, what do you expect in 10 years to come? If it's at a shop, you think of a supermarket. Amen? And if God has started blessing you today, think of 10 years to come. What will you be if you are being blessed by God Himself?
Amen.
The supplier of everything. It is you to tune into the foundation. Amen.
Amen.
Then, this one only comes after leaving. You can write down. After you have left your land. Ninajua, you have so many things in your life that you want to leave. Some of you are tied with so many things. Let us focus on the things you have been tied to. Amen. Others, you have been tied to sin. There is a time you reach a point you feel like you need to sin again. That sin you sinned yesterday.
Amen.
Are tied to bad thinking. You cannot grow. That I cannot grow. God, you gave me this bad husband. This one will not bring anything to my life. That one is the carnal thinking. Amen? Think of good things now. Think that you are this. You are that one. You are that one. If Pastor stands here and says we need cement, tell Pastor, I am thinking that I will put some 10 bags of cement here and I know that God will supply. That one is the good thing that you will be able to do it. Praise God. Though we have very many challenges in life, we live in struggle, but I know if you focus God will do something. This is number one. God will take you to a new place. That is number one. If you decide to leave. If you decide to leave, God is going to take you to another place. Praise God. If you decide to be singing to the Lord, God will take you to another level in singing. If you have decided to partner in the work of God, God will decide to give you more according to his richness and glory. Amen. Am I talking to somebody? It is a decision of let me move. It is a decision that let me start going. Praise God. Who desires to move? If you desire to move, say, Lord Jesus, may you move me to a new place that you will bless me. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It is a decision of moving. It is a decision of let me keep my offering well for the Lord. It is a decision of let me reach out for the Great Commission of preaching to other people. It is a decision. Abraham decided to move from his father's land to be blessed somewhere. Amen. Remember, number one, Abraham had not even one son, even a child. He didn't have. But he was moving. Amen. He was leaving the family. He was leaving everything. But God has told him, move. Yes? God is telling you today, it is the voice of God which is saying that you have to move from that point that you are. Toka mahali ambapo uko apale umezoea. Soka. Wanasipiwe. Soka. I know God can do something. Now that's number one. That if you decide to move, God is going to bless you. Number two, if you decide to move, God is going to change your name to be great. Tell neighbor.
Amen.
Neighbor, I will be called a great person. I will be called a great person. I need an action of faith, by the way. Neighbor, I will be called a great person. Because I have decided to move from my comfort zone to the place God wants me to be. Hallelujah. Who desires to serve the Lord or the pulpit? Who desires? When you're natamani ningetumikia Bwana hata niko kuimba hata ningemwabudu tu kila wakati hata kama ingekuwa vipi mimi nataka nijihusishe na Mungu. Mimi nataka nikuwe katika maombi. Mimi nataka nikuwe katika kikundi cha kuimba. Mimi nataka nikuwe na fadhili hii kabisa. And I know God is going to work upon that one. I know God is going to bless you because you have decided to move.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Amen. I know that one. Surely I know. My God cannot lie. He is going to change because you have decided to move from where you are. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Glory.
Praise God. Number one, I have said God is going to bless you. Number two, I have said God is going to change your title. God is going to change your title from a beggar to a donor. Hey, people are not getting this. You are not going to beg again because God is going to make something. It's going to cause something because they are saying, now move, and you have decided to move, you will donate.
Amen.
Hey, you will not be a recipient anymore. Amen. Amen. Who has that faith with me? Yes. Yes. Let us look at a point whereby we will be donating land for the church.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let us look at a place that we will buy a very expensive machine to our pastor. Amen? Because we have decided to move. Amen? There was a sister that we were fellowshipping with, that sister. And she moved me. When we come to a Sunday like this, she picks an envelope and goes with it at home. Amen. It doesn't matter if it was for Sukuma Wiki or Angetoba kwa shilingi kumi ya Sukuma Wiki abaya shilingi moja.
That's it.
And I'm telling you, I don't see that sister again. She came from Uganda. I no longer see her again. I know maybe she's placed somewhere because she was a giver. Amen. You can be in a foreign land, but God can take you from that land of your mother's or father's land to be taken to a place to bless you. She comes here, she protects all Kenyans. Every Kenyan is looking for that lady to be planted. Amen.
That's it.
She doesn't know Swahili, but she has decided to serve God. God brings the customers who normally speaks English. Our God is God of supplement. He can supply. Amen. And listen to this on the free. If God decides to move you to another place, number one, people will be blessed through you. Hey, I needed an amen. God is going to bless people through you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
People will be saying, if it was not pastor, if it was not sister Nani, if it was not our brother Nani, I would not be here. But because God has helped this one, they are going to be blessed through you.
Amen.
It is a matter of moving.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't budget too much and forget about God. God needs your budget. He just wants to test you. Look at this. When Abraham now decided to move, God blessed Abraham with a son. But God again came back to Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I know you are not the same the way you came here in Nairobi. I know you are not the same. Are we? Yeah? Are we? Are we the same the way we came in Nairobi? God has transformed us, isn't it? Now God is coming back to you.
Amen.
And he's telling you that give this. Even he doesn't mention. You have plenty. You have plenty. God does not even mention this. That he is saying, now it is time to go and give an offering to God. Amen. I know if it was a normal life, this life that we are having, nobody will choose to give that much that Abraham started and decided to do. Amen? But now, Abraham was taken to a place and he was saying, even the son asked him, Father, we have this and we have this and we have even a fire. Which thing are we going to offer to God? Amen? Father, you have a job. You have everything. You have shelter. But God has not told you to give him shelter. He has not given, told him you to give him anything. But it is you. It is you to be willing. Just go before the Lord and tell God that, God, now it is my time. That I have come so that I can give you something. You know, this is a new place. And this is a new pulpit. I'm telling you, there is a blessing that's going to be commanded from this place. If you just decide to join me. Amen. If you decide to leave that pulpit that you left there. You know, some lives, you decide that, now, I'm not going to live this life that I'm living. It is a matter of decision. Now, when Abraham reached to the place where God had told him to do, or to give the offering. Even he tied the son, and he was ready to sacrifice the son. But God, let us clap for our God. But our God is a God of supplement. God that can supply. God said, stop, Abraham. You are not going to do that. I've given you this. Look at this, the bush in the thicket. There is a ram, a fattened ram, that's going to be offered to me. Hey, amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's a matter of willingness. If you decide, God will provide. Amen? If you decide that you have to, if you decide that you are going to offer a motorbike, let us say so. I don't have one, but if I decide that I can offer now a motorbike, do you think that God can deny to give me a motorbike? He will supply. Amen? He will decide that because you are willing to give, I'll give you this so that you can give. Amen. Are you willing? Let me see the sign of hands that now I am willing. I am willing. Tell neighbor. Neighbor. Let us try this. To be willing. To partner with the work of God. Amen. Put down your hands. Number two. That is what things that comes after you have left the land. Yes? Now, you have to know this one. Write down not. N-O-T-E. Not this. Not. If you understand this that I'm going to say, you will know that you don't have anything. If you will understand what I'm saying, you will know that you don't have anything. Number one. Not number one, that everything belongs to God. Everything belongs to God. Whatever you are denying to give God, it is for God. Including yourself. Thank you, my brother. The way you normally do, the way you normally think, that I cannot give this to God, that one thing that you are hiding, it's for God. Everything belongs to God. Let me take you to a book of Job 11. Have you seen that note? You know, when we are teaching, when you find a note, it means that a teacher did some research on it. And it's very important. So everything belongs to? So, if you substitute God with that thing you are saying, it means you don't have anything. And if you don't have God, you don't have anything. Ah. Tell your neighbor. Neighbor. If I don't have God,
I don't have God.
I don't have anything. And because I have God,
everything that I have
is for God. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
So today, we are going out knowing that when God changes your title, you belong to Him. And everything that you belong to, it's for God. That's the book of Job. Job 41, 11. I read that book yesterday and I was amazed. And I decided that God, let it be the way you want. God is asking, who confronted me that I should repay him? Everything under heaven belongs to me. I don't know if you are getting this scripture. Who can come and tell me that, Lord, pay me something? Just know that whatever God will pay you, even if he decides to pay you, the thing that he pays you is his. Praise God. You have really worked, and I know God has blessed you in a smaller way or a bigger way. But don't think that God is moved with that thing. Yes? Because now, under the heaven, everything belongs to Him. Praise God. Including what you have won today belongs to Him. Including your children belongs to Him. Don't shut the children not to go to church. Amen? Hallelujah. Don't tell them not to do anything belonging to church. That one, those children are for God. Amen? It's very important that Everything that you have belongs to God. Don't tell God that, God, you have to repay me. Even if He has blessed me with little, the little you have belongs to God. I need amen.
Amen.
Everything is for God. He is able and capable of exceedingly surpass our expectations and give us a blessing that literally blows our minds. Have you ever been blessed sometime? Yani ukaona ya kwamba Mungu amekubariki mpaka ukachanganyikiwa. Amen. One day I had been sharing this story that I left sukuma wiki. And one brother just here in the White House told me that every evening you will be passing and picking some sukuma wiki to your house. I was feeling like this brother has really communicated. And it was very clear that I needed sukuma wiki. If you trust God for sukuma wiki and He provides, even that big thing you are trusting God to have, He is going to provide.
Amen.
Amen? Amen? If you are trusting God for a job, don't be too quick to say that, God, when you give me this job, I will work for you. Those tricks, we have never been there. Hallelujah. That if God you bless me, I'll bless you too. I'm telling you, it is a fact. It is a trap. If you have ever said that one, let us repent. Raise up your hand. We are repenting today. If you have ever said that, God, if you give me this, I'll do this, and you have never done, say, Lord Jesus. Because I say, out of ignorance, may you forgive me. And today, I've decided not to pledge what I cannot offer. In Jesus' name. Wacha Mungu akufunze kunyamaza. Amen. Yani, we are talking of corruption and you are here trying to corrupt God. That if God you give me, I will give this one. Amen. And that in that corruption deal you cannot satisfy. I'm telling you, be watchful. Pastor said the other day, we have to be watchful. Vigilant. Of those things that we say. Amen? Amen? Another note, number two. God is the supreme giver. God is the supreme giver. God can give you anything. What does the Bible say? Ask in my name. Whatever you desire, and it shall be done what? Shall be given unto you. Because you decided to move, that Lord, I've decided to move from where I am. I'm going to another place that Lord, you decided me to have. And you are the supreme giver. Let me be an example in our congregation that I'm going to be the same. Amen. Who desires God to bless you or her? Who desires the blessing of God? Who desires the blessing? I desire a blessing of God. Amen? Even the blessing of health. Yes? It's very important. Even the provision of food is very important. Amen? But we pray that when God tries to bless you, you should not forget His mercies, His generosity to the work that you are doing. Hallelujah. That's number one. We read this one in John 3:16. He is a supreme giver. God gave His only. When you come to the word only, it means from the yani, hakuna once the hakuna ni hicho tu. There is no any other. It was only one. Praise God.
Amen.
God has given you one talent. One talent. Finally, I know God has given you a talent of juggling in the house of God, isn't it? Yes, you have to praise God using that talent. Very well. Because God, the one that He gave you, God saw that it's very important for you to serve Him with that talent. Amen? But you want us to baby you. Yes, my brother, my sister, it is time for this. It is time for? Because you have decided to move. Read the banner well. If it is Bible study, be available. Because everything you are doing belongs to God. The job you are doing belongs to God. The family you are preparing food to, let that food miss. You will try to see, God bless me with the food. With the food. I'm telling you, because God has provided this season, you come and have time with Him. Prayer. Prayer is very important. Don't think you are too big to pray. Amen? When Jesus was about to be crucified, Jesus prayed. Jesus was spending hours to pray with the disciples. And even he asked the disciples, even you cannot pray for an hour? You are already asleep? Whatever you are chasing outside there, let it stop today. Give concentration to God and mark, because we are starting half of the year. And I know, according to our calendar, Pastor, it is now that next Sunday is the time that we will be officially here. Yes? Official. So, in that office that you are going to get in here from next Sunday, I'm telling you, now decide. Decide. Decision comes from your own heart. When we come in this church and we say that we are blessing Sister Nani, we are blessing Brother Nani, do we find a wife looking at the husband? Knowing that if the husband now will give, I'll have also given. Lies. Praise God. Amen. If your husband or your wife or your child has given something to God, it is him with God, not you as a family. Praise God. Pastor, story of this is personal pastor inside the church. Story of, give me something I give to God. It happens. Amen. In the morning or in the evening, you tell your wife or you tell your husband, you tell your spouse that I need some money to take to church. Who has given in that money? Who has really given? It is that person who has given you the money to give. So today, purpose, that it is me. Don't look at my family that we are going to take this. No, it is you. The foundation should start with you. Those people who are allowed to be given something to take, the pulpit is the children. Because they will be going to the Sunday school. Amen? But you, raise up your hand. Hey, Leo Tatubu. Leo Tatubu. You will know, you don't know. Amen? Atas ipengenda kuwa nismama hapa bere mtakata. Say, not Jesus. I will not make for an offering. Be serious, be serious, be serious. Lord Jesus, I will not make for an offering. Because you are going to move me. And you are going to bless me. Let people see I'm giving my own. In Jesus' name. Ah, hiyo pia nataka makofi. Unajua kwa repentance, repentance is very difficult. Papa Nani doesn't give me money to take for an offering. X from today. Tafuta. Mungu aone bidii yako. Amen? Maybe it is not the husband to be blessed. It was you. So be blessed so that the husband protect the blessing. Amen? Hallelujah. Amen. 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 So God is a supreme giver. He will give us. Number one, he gave the Son. Number two, he gave the Spirit. Look at John 14, 16 to 17. And I'm going to wind up in some few minutes. John 14, 16 to 17. And the Bible says, I will ask the Father. Just write down and you'll read at home. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another counselor. Yes? And the counselor, when you have ever been to a counseling sessions,
Those people, they say the truth.
Amen. So that's why the counselor, it means give you another truth of the matter. May God give you a counselor that will counsel your life. Hallelujah. May God uplift you to understand what the Spirit is saying. Hallelujah. Note number 3. God is the sustainer of all things. God is the sustainer of all things. Philippians 4:19. And I have been reading this one every minute, every time I get to my Bible. And God, my God, will meet all your needs. God meeting all your needs. He has not said that he will meet just half of your needs. God will meet all your needs because you decided to move. Because you decided to settle down and say, God, I've decided to serve you. God, I've chosen this church to be my church. And I'm going to work for my church. God, I've seen other men of God outside there being loved by their members. May you, God, help me to be concerned about my pastors. Amen. Amen. A pastor struggles with the last age up to where he sits, and you are there comfortable, waiting for the blessing. Say, Lord Jesus, give me an understanding to take care of the men of God and the women of God in the church. In the name of Jesus. Yani wewe siku moja siamue tu ulete tu paketi ya maji, wake up. Hata wewe pia useme ni sasa nimeleta. Tuseme hivyo ndio nikutoanishe kitu kwa mfuko. Hallelujah. But you have decided. Decide. Know the need of your father. Amen. Here we are seated like this. We know the needs of our parents that been at home. Even in the morning, they call in the morning. How are you? How is it going to be? Here in Ushago, njaa imetunarua. They know. Even you know. Umejua ni nani amepotea kwa kijiji hapo. Hallelujah. But you don't know the need of your shepherd here. Amen. Tuko sawa?
Yes.
So, from today, understand the need. The need of this place is people to be here. For sure. If we can pay somebody to arrange these things behind the church, if we can do that, then we don't know the need of the church. Amen. Pastor, please, will teach us the work of the church. So, he will sustain you. He will provide all your needs according to his glorious richness in Christ Jesus. Decide and you will see. God is going to give you whatever you want. He will sustain you up to the moment you want to be sustained. Amen. Psalms 23:1, it is very common that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. That is the simple English. The Lord is my shepherd. So if he is my shepherd, what am I lacking? Amen. You have decided to move. God has changed your life. He has given you a new title. And now you are going to be under his shepherdhood. And you are going to prosper. Hallelujah. Jeremiah 1:14. I will satisfy the priests with abundance. God is going to satisfy the priests with abundance and my people with bounty, declares the Lord. God is going to take care of the Levites in the church. If you don't take care of them, God is able. God is. May God give you an understanding that you understand the need of being in church. Ukuwe tuna kiu ya kupenda kanisa. Uwe tuna kiu ya kutaka kuwa kanisani. Bwana asifiwe. Not Sunday to Sunday. Lakini wengine the nature of work sometimes. But I decide that when we meet like this in the Bible study, we grow together. When we meet like this in prayer, we grow together. My conclusion is that the foundation we are building on, may God satisfy you when you work in His field. Say, Lord Jesus, may you satisfy me when I decide to work in your field. May God satisfy you. Amen. Let God fight for you. Let God supply what you need. Let God touch your life. Let God turn around those hard things that you have seen. May God bring satisfaction in your life. Amen. Say, Lord Jesus, may you supply. Because I've decided to work for you in your field. Say, Lord Jesus, give me a title. Every eye closed. Close your eyes. I know you desire to have a title in your life. You have been really praying that God uplift you from that level. People have seen you. People have laughed at you. Watu wamekucheka sana. Wamekuona hauwezi. Wamekudharau. Hata wengine tumetengwa na familia zetu. Kwa sababu hata wakipiga simu, hatuwasaidii. Say, Lord Jesus, may you change my title from today. Don't put me in shame. Because I've decided to work for you. Lord Jesus, bless my generations to come. I have decided to start a new title. Bless me through this title you are giving me. I will not be called a beggar again. I will not be called somebody who brings trouble in the life of people. We may all rise on our feet. If you desire God to change your title, you have been desiring that God nimejiwekea vitu vingi sana. Kwa maisha yangu, nimedhani pesa zangu ndio zinaniokoa. Nimedhani familia yangu ndio inaniokoa. Lakini Bwana umenifunza leo ya kwamba nitoke. Nitoke mahali ambapo nipo sasa hivi. Nisonge katika kiti chako. Nikasonge katika kiti chako. Na Mungu kwa sababu uko na rehema, uko na uwezo wa kunijalia. Kama unataka ombi kama hilo, unaweza songa pamoja. Hata kama tukuje sisi wote, tunataka mwanzo mpya. Haijalishi tumejenga hiki kikubwa, ndio mtoshe. Kama umeamua tu, Mungu akubadilishe. Haijalishi usikuwe tena wengine, wewe ndio umeamua ya kwamba Bwana
ninanguka miguni pako nikuabudu Mwokozi Yesu kando na wewe hakuna mwingine wewe peke yako
padetu hapa
Master nimeanguka
lay our hands on us so that we change our perception.
Kristo. Kuna kuja kia laana ambayo inaweza kuwa kuwa meshika maisha yao. Tunapunja kila nira ambayo inaweza kuwa Bwana amegeuza hatima yao. Tunakaribisha mwanzo mpya maishani mwao katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Sauti yote na bandiko lolote ambao Mungu ameweka juu yao, tunaliondoa sasa katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Tunakaribisha uwepo wa Bwana uanze na wao. Tunakaribisha Bwana mwanzo mpya katika maisha yao wapendwa. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo, tunafungua biashara zao. Tunafungua ndoa zao. Tunafungua uhusiano wao. Tunafungua maisha yao sasa. Tunaweka huru katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Ninafungua kazi kwa wale ambao Bwana hawana ajira. Ninafungua malango ambayo Mungu anaweza kuwa amefunga kwa sababu ya success yao. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Ninanena kinyume na laana za mababu. Wengi wamezunguka mahala pamoja, wameishi kama mababu walivyosema. Lakini kutoka sasa hivi tunaweka kwenye msingi wa Kristo. Na wataanza watatembea katika mwanzo mpya katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Wale ambao wameitwa chekelewa, tunabadilisha majina yao leo. Wataitwa wabarikiwa katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Wale ambao wamechekelewa na kijiji hiki, siku ya leo ninawanasua kutokana na mitego ya kuchekelewa katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Ninawaweka katika lebo mpya. Watakapopita watasema huyo amebarikiwa kwa sababu wako na Mungu. Katika jina la Yesu. Kama Ibrahimu ulimwambia wale watakubariki utawabariki. Ninaomba kupitia kwa Hawa watakubariki kuwa na baraka ambayo itaingia kwa vizazi ambavyo vitakuja. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Asante Jehova, maana unaweza. Wewe ni Mungu ambaye hauni hakimi. Yule yote ambaye hajakutambua, ninaomba Bwana mchana wa leo akaweze kuitanishwa na jina la mbinguni katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Ninaomba kwa sababu ya kuwekwa huru kwa watu wako Bwana. I have this feeling that we need to pray for someone who is afraid about bloodshed. When it's come in my spirit twice now, I see it like two times. I see blood. I don't know, but twice as I'm praying, I just feel it has flashed twice. Blood. I don't know which kind of blood is this. Father, in the name of Jesus, you see in the secret. I don't know why you're bringing these two times. Now you bring in my mind, in my spirit. If there is anyone who is experiencing bloodshed in their lives, I speak healing over their lives. In the name of Jesus. If there is anyone who was to murder or who was to die because of loss of blood, today, Lord, we stand in the gap and we ask you to stop it. In the name of Jesus Christ, we stop every excessive bleeding. In the name of Jesus, in whatsoever form, we refuse that blood will not be shed. In the name of the Lord, I give you praise, I give you the glory and honor. For this is done in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Do you well? May the Lord meet you at the very point of your needs. May He answer your prayers in Jesus' name. We have come to the end of our service. And I want to confirm if there is a cup of tea for all of us. We can have a cup of tea. Then we will be able to go home. I just need a signal that there is tea. 30 for everyone. Very good. So all of us, please make sure you take the cup of tea. Then we'll be able to go. want us to share the grace. May the Lord bless you. You just say amen.
Amen.
May the Lord make his face to shine upon you.
Amen.
May he bless you when you go out and when you come back in.
Amen.
May he bless your water.
Amen.
May he bless your bread.
Amen.
May he bless whatsoever you lay your hands on to do.
Amen.
And may you truly be called the blessed one of the Lord.
Amen.
And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now forevermore. Amen. If you're watching us from wherever you're watching us, this is Precious Faith Church Nairobi, and we are located in Lower Kabete. So if you're around Lower Kabete, you can reach us and we can be able to be happy to host you and to for you to fellowship with us. Our contacts are 07 24 300 387. Again, our contacts are 07 24 300 387. You can reach us, you can support us, you can also partner with us online and also partner with us in person. God bless you, keep you until we see you next time. If you are there and you are not born again, just repeat after me and say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I know that I am a sinner. Forgive me my sins. I choose to be a child of God. From today, I refuse to be in the camp of Satan, and I choose to be in the camp of the children of God. I am born again, and I will live to glorify God. In Jesus' name, I'm born again. Amen. God bless you and keep you until next time.